Good morning. In the last lecture, we have solved problems on single plate clutch and multi plate clutch. In today's lecture, we would like to solve two problems on cone clutches. So, in one of the video, I have explained completely regarding the clutches theory part, that is single plate clutch, multi plate clutch, cone clutch and centrifugal clutch. When I discussed at that moment, I said the analysis part elaboratively I will discuss when we go for the problems point, problems time. So that's why today first I will explain a little bit amount of analysis part on the cone clutches, then we will go for the problem part. Okay, let us see the diagram corresponding to cone clutch. So this is the diagram already you have seen in the earlier theory part of lecture, where there is a cone clutch with inner and outer diameters of D0 and I. So you can see here in this diagram, so the left hand, there left side, there is one shaft, input shaft, okay, and there is another side, output shaft is there. So these two shafts are coupled by a clutch called cone clutch. So you are aware of it, the purpose of the clutch is, say in case of an engine, like an IC engine, even the engine is continuously rotating. If you don't want to transmit the power from engine to the wheels, then this clutch is going to be disengaged. That means the input shaft is continuously rotating, whereas output shaft is not rotating. By disengaging. Once again, I emphasize here, the clutch operation means, disengage. That means clutch is always in contact. Okay, when we want to disengage, then only you break the contact between the two surfaces. So the a cone clutch is a very old, almost you can say, it is the origin of the clutches concept, and nowadays, of course, nobody is using this clutch, but academic point of view, we are dealing this cone clutch. So the problem with the cone clutch is here, because of this tapered portion, which is inserted in the male and female members, if you want to disengage it, the clutch has to be disengaged. Sometimes, there is a problem arises that jamming of two members takes place. That means you will try to disengage, but it may not disengage. So that is one of the problem. That problem will happen because of the steep angles of the cone clutch. Okay. So let us see the technical part, what we require here. So that I will show you what is the mathematical equations which you require. So you can see here the width of the cone clutch is B, okay, and this is from the center R naught, and this is Ri, then this portion will give you the difference of R naught minus Ri, and this angle is alpha. So this is from the geometry we can see the cone outer radius is R naught and the inner radius is Ri. Then the cone surface width is B, and this makes an angle alpha with the horizontal. Okay, so here you can write the simple equation sine alpha is equal to sine alpha. So this is alpha, opposite side R naught minus Ri, okay, and hypotenuse B. So sine alpha is equal to R naught minus Ri by B, or we can also write B is equal to R naught minus Ri by sine alpha. This is one equation which I use in solving the problem. Let me tell you what are the terms in this equation. B is width of the cone surface, R naught is the outer radius of the cone surface, and Ri is the inner radius of the cone surface. 2 alpha is the semicone angle, that means this is the total. Portion. And if you extend it, this total angle is 2 alpha. If this total angle is 2 alpha, then this becomes alpha. That is what I have shown there. A single surface of B is making an angle alpha. And of course, this is my D naught, and this is my DI. So half of it is R naught and RI. Then this simple small piece will be R naught minus RI. Okay. So sine alpha is R naught minus RI by B. I can write B is equal to R naught minus RI by sine alpha. So in the similar way, if you see the forces point of view, so a normal force that is a perpendicular to this surface Fn, it acts. This is the normal frictional force, and this is the force parallel to the axis F. So this is the parallel force F. So then by the similar way of the geometry, we can write Fn, and this is alpha. So the normal force which is acting, this is the normal force which is acting, Fn, and the horizontal force F is this, and this is the alpha. Okay, so by simple geometrical relation, we can write sine alpha is equal to, okay, opposite side by hypotenuse. Sine alpha is equal to F by Fn. Or we can also write in the other way, Fn is equal to, okay, F by sine alpha. Okay, so this is the relation which we require for Fn, okay, that is F by sine alpha. Then the same thing I can write Fn. What is the theory we use for the clutches? The theory which we use for clutches is uniform wear theory. So according to uniform wear theory, what is the equation for the pressure? The pressure and F relation, you are already aware of it. That is P is equal to F by 2 pi R into R naught minus RI. And this is the frictional force, so mu term will come. So Fn is like F plus, I write 2 mu pi R R naught minus RI, okay, by sine alpha. By sine alpha. Here what we have written, R naught minus RI by sine alpha, we have written this as a B. So I will replace that term. Here I get this is 2 mu, okay, pi R into B. We can write this is 2 mu pi R B. Okay, 2 mu pi R B. So this is the one of the equation which we use for some problem solving. Then coming to the another one, what is the torque? What is the torque relation? Torque is equal to, so for a torque, what is the torque equation in case of conical collars? It is half into mu f sin alpha into r naught plus ri. The same thing I will write, half mu coefficient of friction f, okay, by sin alpha into r naught plus ri. Okay, then what is f? We have written here f is equal to fn sin alpha. So I will replace it, f plus mu fn, okay, sin alpha by sin alpha into r naught plus ri. So sin alpha can cancel. Then this can be written as mu fn r naught plus ri by 2. So what is r naught plus ri by 2? That is the mean radius. So you can write simply, this is mu fn rm. You can write this is mu fn rm. This is the another relation. So these relations, we'll solve it in, we'll use it in the problem solving. Okay, so the main important equations you require here is, one of the equation is this, sin alpha is equal to r naught minus ri by b. From there only you get b is equal to r naught minus ri by sin alpha. Then one more relation, this is sin alpha is equal to f by fn. So sin alpha is equal to f by fn. From there you can rewrite fn is equal to f by sin alpha. Then finally, the torque equation, which is known to us for conical collar, okay, that is half into mu into f by sin alpha into r naught plus ri. So this f already we have obtained here, f value is fn sin alpha. The same thing, the f value I have rewritten, and then sin alpha get cancelled. Then leftover terms are mu fn r naught plus ri by 2 is there. So you are aware of it, this is nothing but a mean radius. So you can get mu fn rm. Okay, so using these relations, we would like to solve the problems in the next two problems. Okay, let us attempt for a straightforward problem without any complexities. So whatever the data or whatever the equations just now we have seen, by substituting those equations appropriately, the corresponding values, you get the solution. Only the thing is, you have to identify what is the data given and how to interpret that data, because units are very, very important. Because you can see in some of the problems, they are giving in pascals, and some of the problems they are giving megapascals, and some of the problems they are giving Newton per meter square, kilo Newton per meter square. If you are familiarized with those words, it's okay. Otherwise, you will substitute some data and the problem, which will give you a problem in the final answer. Okay, so let us see what is this problem and what is the data given. So the problem is like this: a cone clutch with a semi-cone angle of 15 degrees transmits 10 kilowatt at a speed of 600 rpm. The normal pressure between the surface in contact is not to exceed 100 kilonewton per meter square. The width of the friction surface is half of the mean diameter. Assume coefficient of friction is 0.25. So up to this, the data given. Then what you have supposed to find out, that is the next part, is determine the first bit, outer and inner diameter of the plates, and the B bit is width of the cone face, okay, and the C bit, or the third bit, is axial force to engage the clutch. So let me first write the information, what is given, the data as it is, then we will solve the problem. So it is a cone clutch. Let us start with the problem, like cone clutch, data given. So data given. So what is the first thing? It is the semicone angle. That is, as per our definition, 2 alpha is 15 degrees. And it transmits a power. How much power? 10 kilowatts. So that is 10,000 watts. At what speed this is delivering the power? Speed of 600 rpm. Okay, then what is the pressure that will be not to exceed? That is the Pmax. Pmax, which is 100 kilonewton per meter square. That is 100 into 10 power 3 newton per meter square. So I'll write this in meter square terminology. So I will get the answers also in meters. Take care about it. In place, if you rewrite this is like 0.1 megapascal, then in your answer you get the value of radius in mm. Then what is the next one? The width of the friction surface, okay, is the mean diameter. So half of the width of the friction surface, which is half of the mean diameter. Width of the friction surface we defined as a B, which is half of the mean diameter, that is DM. So half of the mean diameter is simply nothing but RM. Then coefficient of friction is 0.25. This is the data given. Now let us start solving the problem. B is RM. So what is RM? RM is nothing but R naught plus RI by 2. And what is the equation we know for B? Just now we derived the equation for B in terms of alpha. What is the equation? So the equation we have derived like this. This is B, this is alpha, and this is R naught, this is RI. So this small strip is R naught minus RI. So sine alpha is R naught minus RI by B. RB is equal to R naught minus RI by sine alpha. So the same thing here in place of B, okay, I write, which is R naught minus RI by sine alpha, which is equal to RM. What is RM? That is R naught plus RI by 2. Okay, so R naught plus RI by 2 and R naught minus RI by sine alpha. Alpha is 2 alpha is 15, so alpha is 15 by 2, 7.5 degrees. So you can write this is R naught minus RI by sine 7.5 is equal to half into R naught plus RI. Okay, so you can substitute the angle sine 7.5 degrees, okay, then by rearranging them, so you can write R naught minus RI is equal to sine 7.5 by 2 into R naught plus RI. So by substituting the entire thing of alpha and everything, so I get the answer R naught minus RI is equal to 0.129 R naught plus 0.129 Ri. So rearrange the terms. So let just write it, all the things coming on the right side or left side. Okay, then get the relation. Then you get a relation R naught is equal to 1.29 Ri. So 1.29, you can see 6 Ri. So this is the first requirement for me. What is the relation between R naught and Ri? Then what is available for me? Power is available, and what is speed is available. So from power and speed, you know that power is equal to 2 pi nt by 60, or torque is equal to 60 p by 2 pi n. 60, what is power? 10 kilowatt, 10,000. Okay, by 2 pi n, 600. Then I get the value of torque. So what is this value of this torque? So the torque value which you get here is 159 Newton meter. So the torque also can be obtained by the basic equation using uniform wear theory in case of cone clutch, that is mu, okay, Fn by 2, okay, this is R naught plus Ri. This is also the equation just now we have derived, that is mu Fn by 2 into R naught plus Ri, that is R naught plus Ri by 2 is Rm, that is mu Fn Rm. Okay, so this is also Fn is F by sin alpha, so this is mu F 2 sin alpha R naught plus Ri. So the T value 159 is equal to, what is the mu value, coefficient of friction? Yeah, 0.25. Okay, 0.25. So what is the value of F? That is, where is the value of F? So pressure is there. So from the pressure, the F value can be written according to uniform wear theory. What is the equation for uniform wear theory? So F is equal to 2 pi P R, that is P means not power, pressure, I will write P R, then R I into R naught minus R I. Then already here one R naught plus R I is there. So that is R naught plus R I by 2 sin alpha. What is the alpha? 7.5. Then now I have a relation between R naught and R I. So let me replace this R naught as 1.296 Ri. This is also like 1.296 Ri. Okay, the pressure value is already available. What is the pressure value here? This is 100 into 10 power 3. Substitute this pressure value, 100 into 10 power 3. Okay, then everything you have substituted except the value of Ri. So you have Ri term only left and entire thing you have substituted. So then you get a relation between Ri square and ri cube. Okay, by solving that you can get the value of ri is ri, you get 0.0917 meter. So here you get an equation, that is in terms of ri cube and ri square. Solve that equation, then you get ri. So once you get ri, r naught, there is a relation between ri and r naught. So that relation you can apply. What is the relation between r naught and ri? We have here r naught is equal to 1.296 ri. So let me substitute that value. So that is 0.019. Then I get my r naught. So the value of r naught is 0.1188 meters. That is the first bit. That's the first bit. Then what is the second bit we require? So first one, he has asked to find out the radius inner and radius outer. Both of them I have already solved. So once you get this, the two other parts are simple straightforward substitution. What is the second part is asked? Width of the cone. So width of the cone, what is it? B. So width of the cone is B, which is nothing but in this equation r naught plus ri by 2. So substitute the values of r naught and ri. Okay, just by getting its mean, that is b is equal to r naught plus ri by 2. So you get this is 0.105 meter. That is the second part. So final part, what is it? What is the final part? So what is the axial force to engage the clutch? So the axial force to engage the clutch is as simple as, you know the equation according to uniform wear theory, that is P is equal to F by 2 pi Ri into R naught minus Ri. Now my requirement is to find out this F. What is this F? Simply this is 2 pi P Ri into R naught minus Ri. So I got the value of Ri, I got the value of R naught, and I already having the value of P because it is given 100 Newton, 100 kilo Newton per meter square. So simply substituting it, 2 pi into 100 10 power 3 into Ri 0.0197 into 0.1188 minus 0.097. Just you substitute the entire data, then you get this is force unit. What is the force unit? Newton. This is 1561 newton. So first, if you get this part, then ABC evaluation is very easy. Okay, so what we did, let us see. As it is, the given data has been written. He has given a condition, that is the face width of the cone clutch is half of the mean diameter. That relation I have used here. From that relation I got this equation, that is B is equal to R naught plus Ri by 2. But we know from the basic fundamentals, which I have already derived or I have shown here, that is B is R naught minus Ri by sine alpha. So that is equated to R naught plus Ri by 2. By substituting the value of alpha, let me convert R naught and Ri in single term. There, by solving that equation, I get R naught is equal to 1.296 Ri. After getting this equation, in the given power and speed condition, what is the torque? The torque I have estimated, T is equal to 60 P by 2 pi N. So there, after getting this torque, I have equated the same torque to the basic equation of the conical collar. Okay, that is mu Fn by 2 into R naught plus Ri. You are aware of, or just now we have derived this Fn is F by sin alpha. Okay, so by writing that and substituting the values, mu value is known, F is in terms of 2 pi PR into R naught minus R into R naught plus Ri. Okay, sin alpha, by substituting, I get the value of this Ri. How I get this Ri? Not simply, first I get an equation, a cubic equation. By solving that cubic equation, I get Ri. Okay, I have not written that cubic equation. It is your duty to substitute and get the equation and solve the roots for that equation. Once you get Ri, the relation between Ri and R naught is known. By using that relation, I got my R naught value. So once I get my R naught and Ri, that is the bit A. Second bit is simply width B, is sum average of R naught and Ri, that is given condition that I have substituted, which has resulted me 0.105 meters. And finally, what it is asked, what is the axial force that it transmits? So I did the entire values and finally I got the value of the force, axial force is 1561 Newton. Okay, this is a straightforward problem. In the next problem, we will see a complexity which needs some imagination of the concept given and transforming into your actual cone clutch problem. We will see that problem in next. Okay. The contact surface have a mean diameter of 80 mm. Coefficient of friction is 0.32. What is the minimum torque required to produce slipping of the clutch for an axial force of 200 Newton? If the clutch is used to contact an electric motor with a stationary flywheel, determine the time needed to attain the full speed and the energy lost during slipping. Motor speed is 900 rpm and the moment of inertia of the flywheel is 0.4 kg meter square. Let us see how we can solve the problem. What is the data given? First, let us write semicone angle. So what is semicone angle? 2 alpha. How much it is? 12.5 degrees. That means alpha is 12.5 by 2, which is 6.25 degrees. Then contact surfaces have a mean diameter of 80 mm. D mean is 80 mm and coefficient of friction mu 0.32. Then what is the minimum torque required to produce slipping of clutch for an axial force of 200 Newton? So if the clutch is used to connect an electric motor with a stationary flywheel, there is a flywheel, okay, the flywheel is connected with the clutch. Determine the time needed, okay, to attain the full speed. So we have to find out T, time needed, okay, that is the first thing. And what is the next one? Data given, motor speed is given. How much motor speed? N is, that is 900 rpm. Then moment of inertia I is 0.4 kg केजी मीटर स्क्वायर. लेट अस सी हाउ वी कैन सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. वी हैव ए रिलेशन टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू आई अल्फा. दिस इज ऑलरेडी नोन टू यू फ्रॉम द बेसिक फंडामेंटल्स, दैट इज टी इज इक्वल टू आई अल्फा. सो टी फ्रॉम द क्लचेस, this is the cone clutch. So what is the value of T as per our equations? Mu, okay, F Rm by sin alpha, that is T. So this is equated to I alpha. So let me substitute the data which is available with me. Mu, what is the mu? 0.32, and F 200. So mean radius, diameter is 80, then 40 into 10 power minus 3, I am converting it into meters, okay, then by sine 6.25, which is equal to I alpha. So what is I? 0.4 alpha. By solving this, you get the value of alpha. So what I did, the basic equation which I know, torque is equal to I alpha. So that I is known to me, alpha is unknown. So torque, how I applied, this is a cone clutch. The equation for the cone clutch, torque transmitted is mu F Rm by sin alpha. So I know mu value, F value, Rm value, alpha value. Everything has been substituted and I got the value of alpha 29.5 radians per second square. So what is alpha? What is alpha? So alpha is nothing but omega by T. So this is alpha is the angular acceleration. So how you get angular acceleration? So you can get it by angular velocity by time. So I can equate alpha 29.5, where omega is 2 pi n by 60 into T. So what is my n? 900. 60 into T. With this, I get the value of T. So this T value, okay, which you get 3.187 seconds. This is the T value, which you get 3.187 seconds. Okay, then what is torque? Torque is I alpha. T is I alpha. So I already having the value 0.4 and alpha having 29.5. So 0.4 into 29.5, which you get 11.82. Newton meter. Torque is this and time is this. So our job is to find out time. Time is already calculated. That is the first part. Then what is the second part is asked? Okay, let us see what is asked. Motor speed is 900 rpm and the moment of inertia of the flywheel is 0.4. then determine the time needed. Already we have calculated and the full speed and energy lost. Energy lost during slipping off. Energy lost. So how to get the energy lost? So the energy transmitted energy transmitted, okay, that is T omega T. What is this T? T is the torque, omega is the angular velocity, and T is the time. So what is capital T? Just now we have calculated 11.82. And what is omega? This 2 pi n by 60. Okay, n is 900, you can substitute. And what is the time? 3.187. So this is energy transmitted. So how much this is energy transmitted? 3553 Newton meter. 3553 Newton meter. So this is energy transmitted. Then what is the energy gained by flywheel? Energy by flywheel. That is half I omega square. So what is the value of I and omega already known to us? So I is 0.4 omega 2 pi n by 60 whole square, and substitute n is 900. Then you get this is 1776.5 Newton meter. Then energy lost is energy transmitted and energy of the flywheel. Difference is energy lost. E lost is energy transmitted minus energy of flywheel. So energy transmitted is 3553, and energy gained, energy by a flywheel is 1776.5. So you get the remaining thing, law power remaining energy is once again 777.5 Newton. Okay. The same problem at the this part you can solve by the another method, that is the other method is like this. The another method how you can do that also I will tell you. So what is initial energy angle turned by the driving shaft? So driving shaft rotated by an amount of theta 1. Driving shaft rotated by theta 1. How to get this driving shaft rotated by theta 1? Omega T. So what is omega? You know that 2 pi n by 60 into time T, which is 3.187. So you get this part is 150, okay, 0.2 radians. You get this is 150. So by substituting this, you get this is 300.4, okay, radians. Then what is the driven shaft angle? Driven shaft angle theta 2. How you can get the theta 2? Theta 2 we can get omega naught T plus half into alpha into T square. What is omega naught? Initial velocity. What is the initial velocity of the flywheel? 0 into T, of course 0, plus half. What is alpha here? 29.5. Into time. What is the time? Time is 3.187 square. So here you get this is 150.2 radians. Okay, 150.2 radians. Then energy lost is equal to T into theta 1 minus theta 2. That is, what is T? We got T 11.82. 11.82 into 300.4 minus 150.2. Okay, so by this way also you get 1775 newton meter. You can solve by this method or this method, both gives the same solution. Okay, 1770.5 newton meter.